See, based on my real example, when I was sitting in my interview, my father runs a jewelry shop. So they asked me a current affairs related to my father's business. So understand this thing. Whatever current affairs is related to yourself, like related to the periphery of what you have created around yourself, you should be well versed with those current affairs. It's just like if someone's father is running a cloth, is running a textile shop. Then you should be aware, like, what is the recent initiatives that government is being taken in the textile sector.
Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to this session on SEBI graded offers. So today I'm going to have Adesh Singhal with me, who cleared SEBI examination 2020 in the year 2021. He's received very good marks. In fact, if you can see the marks that I've just mentioned here, in English he's received 66, in paper 277, and in the interview 9 out of 15 after conversion. तो इनके नंबर बहुत अच्छे हैं. द प्रिपरेशन हैज बीन वेरी टॉप नॉच एंड देयर फोर टूडे सेशन इज गोइंग टू बी अ लिटिल डिफरेंट. आज के सेशन में वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू हैव हिम ऑन द स्टेज एंड ही विल जस्ट टॉक अबाउट हिज प्रिपरेशन. हाउ डिड ही गो अबाउट इन फेज वन एंड फेज टू. पेपर टू में क्या क्या उन्होंने किया. वॉट थिंग्स डिड ही कीप इन माइंड. वॉट सोर्सेज डिड ही यूज. वॉट टिप्स डज ही हैव फॉर यू इफ यू आर स्टार्टिंग अ प्रिपरेशन नाउ, स्पेशली एज अ स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम द नॉन कॉमर्स बैकग्राउंड. तो क्या क्या चीज़ें आपको ध्यान में रखती हैं, वो सारी चीज़ें आदेश विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट दैट. ओके, सो लेट्स हैव आदेश एंड लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द डिस्कशन विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम.
Good evening, aspirants. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. I'm a chartered accountant qualified in November May 2017. Joined Wipro in November 2017. Worked for almost 2.5 years in this company and then took sabbatical for the preparation of civil services exam. Then after 1 month of preparation, I realized that civil service is just like a just like very uncertain exam, that you don't have any guarantee that you will clear this exam. And that point of time, I think that I should have a plan B, or I should start thinking for one better option that I can get rather than a private job. And then I started researching. Then I started my research. I go through the website of SEBI, I go through the website of RBI, NABARD, and many other regulators in India. And then I choose SEBI because the thing is, SEBI and my approach is almost same. Like, we if I say in very limited words, like, we both love to build trust, and like the SEBI loves to build trust in the minds of investor that their money are safe, and I love to build trust in the minds of the people that I have met in my life. So at that point of the idea is that I can relate my purpose of life with the organization, and I can give fruitful results to the organization when I will work in this. But at that point of time, I was not very much sure that I will sit in the exam in the coming year or not. Now, the thing is, I believe in coincidences, and the one coincidence that happens to me was my sister visit to my home, and due to her, I filled the form, and this is something from where I started thinking for SEBI 2020 exam, that yes, I will appear in this exam and I will definitely going to prepare for this exam. Now in the July, I filled the form for SEBI, and after filling the form, though I filled the form after reading the full notification whether I am capable to do this or not, but at that point of time itself, I was not completely into SEBI's preparation because my UPSC attempt was due in October 2020. But due to some lack of preparation, due to some mistakes which every aspirant is doing in their life, I think I was not able to make it in October 2020 prelims. Then my focus shifted from UPSC to SEBI, because my SEBI, I was aware that SEBI attempt will going to happen within 4 or 5 months, within next 4 or 5 months from October 2020. So my approach was changed and I started preparing from SEBI's point of view. Now the first thing which I did and which I believe every aspirant should do is read the notification properly, and this is the key. If you read the notification properly, like if you are like me, and I am sure that many of you are like me only, that we do have a fear of general awareness, that the syllabus is so vast there and they can ask anything under the sky. So after reading the notification properly, I got a confidence that the general awareness cannot become a hurdle in my success for this particular exam. For the SEBI's exam, I was sure that general awareness will not become a hurdle in my success, because my quantitative aptitude, reasoning and English was far better than what required in the exam to pass that particular phase. And the second part of a technical one, like a paper two of both the phases, that this is something which I can relate with my UPSC optional, because commerce and accounts was almost, syllabus was almost same. So I decided that I will start preparing commerce and accounts first from the SEBI's point of view. Like I will go into the depth which SEBI requires from in their exam. And then if something extra will require you from UPSC point of view, then I will think of it when UPSC optional will become my limelight. Now, how I started my preparation. So first thing, we can divide our discussion in the phases, like paper one of phase one. So it was quantitative aptitude, reasoning, English and general awareness. So the quantitative aptitude, reasoning and English. Now here that everyone is listening, that we should go through the previous year questions or past year exams. Here's the key. Past year exam or previous year question is useful here, because you will get an idea that which topic is being asked on a regular basis from these sections. And because if you took any book of quantitative aptitude, reasoning and English, you will get an idea that the syllabus is very vast. Like there's no end to the syllabus, but you have to limit yourself in preparation, because this is competition. You don't have to be an expert in the syllabus, you just have to clear the exam. So now, after reading the past year exams or past year syllabus, past year papers, I made a list of 10 topics from quant, 10 topics from reasoning, 10 topics from English. And though I at that point of time, I skipped the general awareness part. Now, those 30 topics, I started preparing for those 30 topics. And my strategy to prepare them was read or like watch the videos on those topics and appear for the mock test topic wise. Not just a complete mock test of a quantitative aptitude, first appear for the mock test topic wise. How this topic wise mock test will help you? These topic wise mock test will going to help you in the way that you will come to know which particular topic is killing your maximum time in the exam. And in that way, you would be able to skip those topic in the exam if you want to, or if you are in a safe position. Then like if you know that I have already done 15 questions in the whole section of quantitative aptitude, and these 5 questions I know, but they will kill my time for another questions in the logical reasoning section or in the English section, then you can skip those questions. And this is the point where mock test will help you, especially for quant, reasoning and English. Now come to the paper two of both the phases. First of all, the syllabus is same. You don't have to prepare anything extra for phase one and phase two. The syllabus is completely same. Now, my strategy to prepare this particular paper. So I will divide my strategy in two parts. First, which books I have referred and how I prepared other subjects. First, so the books which I have referred is mostly from the ICI material and the NCERT material and the few authors' book. So if you want, for the Companies Act, I have referred CA, IPCC material and CA final company law. Stick to the company law. Second part would be the management. The first part is NCERT, BST, class 11th and 12th. Second part would be the book of Mr. T.N. Chhabra. Now the third subject would be accounts. First one would be NCERT and here 11th and 12th both, and do the practicals, like do the all the practicals here. Practicals most important. Then the second source that you can refer is the ICI Material Tale IPCC. Fourth one would be costing. CA Institute IPCC material, and I can guarantee you if you will cover this material fully, then costing will be covered in a very depth way. Fifth one would be economics. Here NCRT is must. NCRT class 11, 12 is must that you have to do. Though to be honest, the economics is my weak area, so I just stick my preparation to NCRT. But yeah, I purchased one book, and that is Amit Sachdeva's book for economics. And the sixth one would be Indian financial system. The logic is like, we don't have any specific book for this particular section of the syllabus, Indian financial system. So what you can do is you can start referring to the RBI website, because RBI website has lot of material about this particular topic. You can refer the FAQs and the laws that has been uploaded on the RBI's website. And in the same way, you can also refer to the SEBI's website, because SEBI has all the laws related to the securities market on their website. So these are the six topics which we have in our paper, two of both the phases, and you can refer those these materials, which will be very helpful in your preparation, definitely. Now coming to the how should we prepare, how should we start our preparation for these topics? Because see, you have the material, you have the sources, but if you don't have the right strategy how to start your preparation, being my focus for not for the commerce student, my major focus is on the non-commerce background student. So you have to think that you have not read these particular topics at any time in your life. So you should start in a very sequence way, because you are already a graduate, and it's very tough for a graduate to start from the base. So your first subject that you will read from this particular syllabus should be management. And why I'm choosing management, because management, if you go by the subject, it is a theory based subject. But if you read it by heart, you will realize that each and every management topic, you can relate it with your personal life. And this is the key, like if you can visualize the topics in your mind, that if I'm reading a motivation or a leadership chapter, and I'm reading any theory of the leadership, and if you can apply these theory, and you will research, you will think about these theory, you will realize that yes, I have applied this theory in my life in some point of time. And in that way, you will be able to grab that topic in your mind and in your heart as well. And when the topic will come in your exam, you will perform better in a far better way. Now, after the management, now let's introduce you with the commerce and accounts. And now start preparing for the accounts, because it is the basic of all the subjects. Now it is the basic for commerce and account. It is the basic for costing. Even it is the basic of this economics as well, if you will read. So start preparing with the accounts. Now management, first complete the management, read all the management topics, because motivation chapter will also help you in your preparation, how to motivate yourself. And now after this management, accounts, now introduce yourself with the most boring subject of this whole syllabus, and that is law. Now law, the key, because the law is completely based upon the rectification, how you can rectify, or how you can store the facts in your mind, because the question that SEBI asks is based on facts, is not based on analysis. Now they are asking you which form needs to be filled in that particular case, what is the section number for this thing, what is the penalty for this thing. So it's all based on how much facts you can store in your mind. So the way to store those facts is to discuss these facts with your friends or with your family members or with anyone you want to. Like in my case, if there's a penalty that needs to be charged on the auditor for any misdoing or any wrongdoings, I discuss these penalties with my mom. After reading the particular section from the book, I go to my mom and I just say, मम्मा अगर ऑडिटर ये गलती करेगा तो उसको इतना चार्ज देना होगा. एंड आफ्टर रिपीटिंग दीज थिंग्स टू और थ्री टाइम्स आई बिलीव आई कैन गारंटी यू दैट दिस थिंग विल गेट स्टोर इन योर माइंड. सो द फर्स्ट की फॉर मैनेजमेंट इज विजुअलाइजेशन, फॉर लॉ इज डिस्कशन. नाउ फॉर अकाउंट्स एंड कॉस्टिंग, वॉट आई कैन सजेस्ट यू इज दीज दो दीज टॉपिक्स आर बेस्ड अपॉन लाइक सम formulas, like we have, you have certain methods how to pass an entry for accounts. Like if you are purchasing some shares, what is the method to pass those entries? It is written in the law. But if you will try to identify the logic behind why the entries is being passed in such a way, like why this particular cost is being charged to my costing account, why the cost is being bifurcated at this point of time in the joint product and byproduct topic, then you will realize that the costing accounts is the most easiest subject in the whole syllabus. Because suppose if you are preparing for commerce and accounts, then definitely you have wear baniya mindset in your attitude ki ha ye mera paisa hai. And costing is something ki har paise ko jab main ye samjhunga ki jo bhi paisa kharch ho raha hai wo meri jeb se kharch ho raha hai, I will also realize ki mere ko costing kam se kam kaise lani hai wo mere ko samajh mein aayega. So logic understanding from the logic point of view, not from rectification, at least in the practical subjects. And for the law I will say discussion, and for the management I will say visualization. These three keys if you will follow for these four technical subjects, I can assure you that you will be prepared very well in comparison to other aspirants. Now for the remaining two subjects, one is Indian financial system and one is economics. Indian financial system is something which you are expected to know because you are applying for a financial organization in India. So you have to read. It's not about you have to learn about this. It's just about you have to read about the organizations, like which law is governing this organization which I am appearing for. And from the economics point of view, like if you are appearing for any regulator exam in India, then you should be at least know about the basic concepts of economics. Though I have not well versed with economics topics, but yes, I will say ki if someone is good in economics, then it's an advantage, because economics is something which we cannot learn in just 1 year. It takes time to learn economics. So these are the six subjects these are the sequence that I followed in my preparation, and these are the sources which I have followed in my preparation. Though like I prepared my notes from these papers, but notes, the way of making notes, the way of preparing notes is one thing, but what attitude you should maintain in your mind while preparing the notes, the attitude is like you don't have to show your notes to anyone. This is for you. You are not getting judged how you are writing in the notes. Just prepare the notes for yourself. Whatever writing you want to choose, whatever language you want to choose, just prepare the notes in a way that you can understand yourself. आफ्टर प्रिपेयरिंग दोज नोट्स, इतना तो कम से कम करना कि खुद को समझ में आए. इतना गंदा भी नहीं कि खुद भी ना समझ पाओ, कम से कम इतना तो हो कि खुद समझ पाओ उस नोट्स को. नाउ दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई प्रिपेयर फॉर माई फेज 1 एंड फेज 2. नाउ लेट्स कम टू द इंटरव्यू. सो इंटरव्यू इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट विच यू कैंट क्वालिफाई जस्ट रेक्टिफिकेशन ऑफ फैक्ट्स और knowing about India. The key to clear the interview, which I feel and I think it's useful, is first you should have attitude. You should have a good attitude towards the organization. Like why SEBI? Everyone should be very clear about this question. It is not something like the organization is paying me 18 lakhs, so I just want to choose this organization. Because at any point of time, if the interviewer will realize this thing that you are appearing for this exam just for money, yeah, he is not going to choose you for any reason, because he knows that there are other organization which is paying more, and when you will get an opportunity, those organization you will leave their organization. And no interviewer wants to hire a talent which is not stable in their organization. So you should show your seriousness to the interviewer that yes, I am here for this organization because this is the reason, and that reason should be based upon certain logics. Now second thing is, which I feel, is research on yourself. See, हम लोगों को हमसे बेहतर कोई नहीं जानता. नो वन नोज अस बेटर देन अस. सो लाइक यू शुड बी कॉन्फिडेंट इनफ इन वॉट एवर यू आर सेइंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ. यू कैन बी आस्ट एनीथिंग अबाउट योर सेल्फ. इट्स जस्ट लाइक वॉट एवर योर प्रोफाइल, यू कैन बी आस्ट एनीथिंग. They can ask you anything from your profile. Now the third thing is know about the organization. This again comes like if they are asking you something about SEBI, they are asking you something about securities market. You should be well versed with these topics. And I, to be honest, I'm keeping my discussion limited to the general stream. So you should be very clear about the SEBI. Now the fourth thing which comes is like current affairs. Now the current affairs is not something ki aapko pure India ke bare mein pata hona chahiye. Like you start reading the last 1 year current affairs just for that 10 or 15 minutes interview. See, based on my real example, when I was sitting in my interview, my father runs a jewelry shop. So they asked me a current affairs related to my father's business. So understand this thing. Whatever current affairs is related to yourself, like related to the periphery of what you have created around yourself, you should be well versed with those current affairs. It's just like if someone's father is running a cloth, is running a textile shop, then you should be aware like what is the recent initiatives that government is being taken in the textile sector, or what are the issues that textile sector is facing. So this is the current affairs that you need to prepare. Like if your father is from agriculture background, then you have a lot to prepare from the current affairs point of view. So now the key to this interview is, now Mr. Anuj is asking me how I build my confidence for the interview. Like since I was preparing for almost for 1.5 years in a single room, I was not interacting with many of my friends. So how I build up that confidence to face some unknown panel in that interview room. And I found this technique very useful if it applies to you. So the thing is, I applied to various private jobs on the LinkedIn platform, and they shortlisted my CV and they started taking my interview. This is one thing. Now suppose if you have not that experience that company will shortlist your CV. Now how you can build this confidence? Just start at the time of interview, start sending high message to at least 5% which you have not discussed, you have not talked since last almost 1 year, 1 or 2 years. That could be anyone. That could be a friend, that could be a family member, that could be a teacher, that could be anyone. And once you start that discussion, just ask them ki chalo kuch baat karte hain, ab baat karte hain apne bare mein. It's not ki kuch bhi baat karte hain, apne bare mein baat karte hain. Then you will be well versed. Jab aapko bataoge main ye kar raha hu apni life mein, maine ye kiya tha, so they will definitely ask, they will fire some questions on you. Like tune ye kiya tha to ye kyon kar raha hai. Jaise mere sath hua tha, someone asked me ki I took sabbatical for UPSC, now I am in SEBI interview, why? And the same question was repeated by interviewer in the interview. So this anything can be benefited. So the point is, you have to drop your shy nature. Like you have to start talking to person when you are appearing for interview, at least just 15 days prior to the interview, start talking to the person. Just don't be a bookish person at that point of time ki main se padhunga mera ho jayega. Nahi, aapko logo se baat karna hai, because these are not uncle aunties which you are comfortable with. These are some unknown persons which you have to face. You have to face with confidence, because if confidence lacks, then there is highly less chance of success in that particular interview room. So these are some key points which I want to share with you regarding my strategy and my preparation and the attitude that I had maintained in my preparation, the reason why I choose SEBI. Lastly, I just want to mention certain points. How to keep yourself motivated? See, the motivation should come from inside. Should not be outside motivation. Should not like you are preparing for your family, you are preparing for your friends. Once you will realize that you are preparing for yourself, then I think you will be able to give more efforts in the preparation. The second thing which I have come across is like, इस बार थ्योरी का वेटेज इतना था, प्रैक्टिकल का इतना वेटेज था. डोंट गो इनटू सच क्वेश्चंस. सी, सीबीएस डिफाइंड द सिलेबस. एज एन एस्पिरेंट, आवर रेस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इज टू कंप्लीट द सिलेबस इन एवरी एस्पेक्ट. थ्योरी में कितना आया था, प्रैक्टिकल में कितना आएगा, अगली बार क्या पूछा जाएगा, किसी को नहीं पता. नो वन नोज कि अगली बार क्या पूछा जाएगा. यू जस्ट हैव टू प्रिपेयर योरसेल्फ विद 100%. हेंस वंस यू विल बी प्रिपेयरिंग एंड वंस यू आर प्रिपेयर्ड विद 100%, I am very much sure that when you will lie down after giving the exam on your bed at the night time, the satisfaction that you will have in your mind, na, that will be at utmost level. Yeah, maine apna 100% diya tha. I have prepared whatever I can do my best. I have done that. and then this is the maximum satisfaction that level that I have achieved through this preparation journey, through this journey of my preparation. And this is the key that I just want to share. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, Adesh. I think that was a beautiful session. Kafi lamba bhi liya hai. The first time being on screen, I think that must have been a beautiful experience. I've taken the mic now. So that was the entire session. There are one or two small things jo mujhe laga ki baad mein discuss kar sakte hain. Number one, if you're preparing on your own and economics is a problem, then Khan Academy videos which are there on their website, which are completely free, they can be used. Aur inhone tips aapko bataye bahut acche. Companies Act mein kya bataya tha? Companies Act was
discussion
was in Companies Act. Please keep this in mind, especially for non-commerce students. I think ye hum bhool jate hain choti choti cheeze.
Visualization.
Management mein was visualization. And
accounts
में logic,
costing
और accounts दोनों में logic, मतलब कि आपको देखना है कि मेरे पैसे कहाँ लग रहे हैं, या तो वो खर्चा हो रहा है accounts में, मतलब revenue आ रहा है, कुछ ना कुछ खर्च हो रहा है, so where am I spending money, where am I receiving money from, वो logic आप use करोगे if you think that every penny that is going out or coming in the books is actually going out from your pocket, तो फिर वो logic बहुत easily आपको समझ आएगा. So these are the small things that I think Adesh has beautifully brought down. I would like to thank him again for giving out such a beautiful session for you guys. Isse zyada comprehensive list aapko nahi mil sakti hai. Useful plus comprehensive. Isko agar aap use karoge, believe me, in the next 4-5 months you can very well prepare on your own for the examination. Bahut acche se taiyari kar sakte ho without any outside support. Aur jo bhi aapko outside support milega YouTube pe, otherwise through me and many others, that can act as an add-on. कि भाई ये भी कर लेते हैं, ये भी add-on कर लेते हैं, revision sessions भी ले लेते हैं end में, to see how are we performing and what are the problems that we have. Okay, so those were the things that you. Yes, there was one thing, a mock test. कि you want to talk about that? कि mock test में कैसे? ठीक है, तो mock test की एक तो आदेश ने दो चीज़ की थी. एक तो फेज वन में क्वांट रीजनिंग इंग्लिश में उन्होंने टॉपिक वाइज मॉक्स लिखे थे, और दूसरा एनालिसिस ही शेयर्ड इट विद मी दैट ही स्पेंट अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम ऑन एनालाइजिंग एवरी क्वेश्चन इन द मॉक. तो उनकी स्ट्रैटेजी या फिर उनका लॉजिक क्या था कि अगर मैंने 500 क्वेश्चन किए, लेट्स से एवरी पेपर हैज 50 क्वेश्चंस, 10 पेपर्स, 500 क्वेश्चन मैंने प्रैक्टिस किए, एवरी क्वेश्चन हैज 4 आंसर चॉइसेस, मतलब 4 टॉपिक कहीं ना कहीं टच हो रहे हैं. तो इन शॉर्ट 2000 क्वेश्चन में प्रिपेयर करके जा रहा हूँ. नाउ दिस इज पॉसिबल ओनली व्हेन यू आर एनालाइजिंग एवरी मॉक. हर मॉक के हर क्वेश्चन को आप एनालाइज कर रहे हो, देख रहे हो, ओके दीज आर द 4 ऑप्शनल्स गिवन, एम आई क्लियर अबाउट दीज ऑप्शंस, क्या ये 4 टॉपिक्स जो ऑप्शंस के थ्रू हैं क्या वो मुझे आते हैं या नहीं आते हैं. इफ दैट इज क्लियर देन ओनली यू मूव फॉरवर्ड, अदरवाइज यू स्पेंड टाइम ऑन दोज 4 ऑप्शंस. सो यू आर इन शॉर्ट कवरिंग 4 क्वेश्चंस और 4 टॉपिक्स एट वन टाइम. तो इस तरह से आप यू आर कवरिंग 2000 क्वेश्चंस इन वन गो. ओके, तो ये छोटी छोटी चीज़ें हैं, एनालाइजिंग मॉक्स, कवरिंग मॉक्स टॉपिक वाइज, एंड टेकिंग एज मेनी मॉक्स एज पॉसिबल बिफोर द एग्जामिनेशन, बिकॉज एग्जामिनेशन इज ऑब्जेक्टिव. तो और आपको एग्जाम क्लियर करना है, यू डोंट हैव टू गेट अ PhD इन दैट सब्जेक्ट. तो आपका ऑब्जेक्टिव है कि भाई उस एग्जाम को क्लियर करें. तो एक सिमुलेशन आपको मिलेगा, इफ़ यू राइट मोर एंड मोर मॉक्स इट विल हेल्प यू बी मोर कॉन्फिडेंट एंड क्लियर द एग्जामिनेशन फास्टर. ओके, सो दीज आर द स्मॉल थिंग्स रिगार्डिंग मॉक्स दैट ही शेयर्ड विद मी. एनीथिंग एल्स दैट यू वुड वांट टू? So that's a lot, guys. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'm very, very certain that this session is going to help you prepare better, prepare smarter for the examination. Take care. Bye-bye.